My name is Héléna, I'm 45 years old and I live in a very small country in Africa. 30 years ago I had a son and for 30 years I haven't been able to find him. When I was 15 years old, I was expelled from my school. My angry father asked me to find a new school on my own, so I found a school 10 kilometers away from our house and every day I left home at 4 a.m. and only came back in the evening and walked 20 kilometers every working day. I was making the same journey for 2 months when my classmate offered me to come and live with her. She had told her mother about me and her mother saw fit to write to my parents. From then on, I left home on Sunday afternoons and only came home on Friday evenings because the rest of the days I spent with my classmate Mary. Mary was 3 years older than me and she knew many things. With my size, many thought I was older and often when I was dating Mary, she would always tell me to tell people that I was 18 years old. Sometimes when I was asked she would rush to answer for me and say that I was 19 years old. Mary had a relationship with their neighbor's husband. Every day after class we would go to her neighbor's house before going home and stay there until the neighbor's husband returned. If the neighbor came home smiling, there was no appointment that day, but if he came home angry, we had to go to their place of appointment, so that was the rule. After the meeting, Mary would bring back a lot of money with which we bought clothes and linen, and she always gave me some money. One day I caught Mary and the neighbor whispering. When they saw me, Mary said, "But go ahead and tell him yourself," and the neighbor spoke up and said, "Héléna, we have a new director who has just arrived, so we are having a party this weekend if you can come." Before saying anything, Mary replies in my place and says we will come. On my way out, I told Mary why you always like to speak in my place. I added that I didn't even have an outfit to go to a party and Mary tells me she will find a solution. On the day of the invitation, Mary did my hair and gave me her most beautiful dress. When I arrived at the party, all eyes were on me, there were only gentlemen, so I sat down and had a glass of juice. Then a gentleman approached me, we began to discuss and he asked me why I was only taking juice. I told him that alcohol was reserved for grown-ups and then he offered to try what he was talking. He poured something in my glass of juice and the conversation continued. I remember feeling dizzy and a little dizzy, but the memories of the rest of the party are still hazy. The next day, I woke up in a room, naked and alone with nothing but a giant mirror in front of me. I try to get up but I can't, my legs have become heavy. I had pain everywhere and especially my head. I started shouting for help, suddenly the door opened and the nice gentleman who was talking to me during the party came in and smiled and said, "You are finally awake." I asked him several questions at once, "Where am I, where are my clothes and where is my friend, what did you do to me?" I started shouting, shouting and he told me in Yiddish to shout, "There is nobody here. It's Sunday and all the staff absent, it's just you and me." I asked him nicely to give me my clothes, I got dressed and when he turned around to get me a glass of water, I ran to the door and ran away. I don't even know what time it was, but I went straight home. Walking was a bad walk, very bad, but I had no choice. The following week I didn't go to class, I couldn't feel my body. I had pain everywhere, inside and outside. When I went back to class, Mary wasn't there. All my questions remained unanswered. Sometime later my parents forbade me to go to school. At home, my sister and brother didn't leave me in peace anymore, insults all the time, threats and even said that I was a failure and that I brought shame to the family. This pregnancy was really a burden for me because even my friends didn't come to see me anymore. Meanwhile, the nice gentleman of the party was looking for me, he had heard about my pregnancy since he knew that he was the author, he did his best to find me. The famous gentleman was the general manager of a public company in the area. He was 43 years old and had no children from all his previous marriages. His entourage had advised him to be with a younger woman and then he came across me, he drugged me, raped me and I became pregnant. I couldn't tell my parents about this because even if I had told them, it wouldn't have changed anything at all because my parents couldn't do anything against him because of his social position. When he found me, he came immediately to my parents, and that's when he married me. I went to the wedding when I was 15 years old. I was so young that some things I barely understood. My husband needed a real wife and I was not ready. Abuse, infidelity was my daily life. He brought his mistresses into my house. All this, even if I went home, my parents would send me home, because even in the eyes of the law, they had no right to keep me. After giving birth, my son had just turned 7 months old, and it was already a habit for me to sleep alone with my child. That night my husband disappeared from the room as usual. My son was feverish and I had to find him so that he could take us to the hospital. I searched the whole house but he wasn't there. I decided to go and see my girlfriend, who was sleeping in the visitor's room. When I opened the door, I found them in action. I screamed and went back to my room. A few minutes later, he came back into the room, and we started arguing, but this time he beat me like hell. I waited until the morning after he left for work, picked up my son, and we left. When we arrived home, my mother didn't even try to find out what was taking me, and she started screaming. I had no choice this time but to undress in front of my parents to show them my body. My father burst into tears and promised not to let me go back into my marriage. So my father sent a letter to my husband to cancel the marriage, but he still let him come and see his child. 4 months later, he phoned and said he was coming to pick up the child for the weekend. I prepared my child, but I didn't know it was my last time with him. So my husband came by, we stayed for a few moments, and then he left with the child. 2 days and two nights passed. Usually he would take the child for just one day. The anxiety was great. I decided to go home to see what was going on, but when I arrived, the house was empty, just a bag in the living room, and it was my few things. My husband had left with my child, and until those days, 30 years ago now, I never saw my son again, and I never had any more children.